Now, I could tell you all about how great Glee is, but I think I'm gonna let some friends of mine show you instead.
Which one of you is, Sandy?
Ooh! Mr. Groban, we are so honored that you came here today.
I came here to tell you.
Yes, sir.
Stop emailing me. This is a restraining order. Stop sending me nude photos. Stop calling me. I don't know how you got my number. I don't know how you got my number again after I changed it. But I don't want any more of your edible gift baskets or locks of your hair. And I don't want to read any more of those sonnets you wrote for me.
That stuff got crazy, dude.
How did this happen? I look like a crazy person. That's not me. Wow, I didn't know the vein on my neck could stick out like that. We've been going at it for a week, ever since the decongestant incident when Figgins brought Sue in to co-run the Glee Club. I'm so ashamed of myself. She's turned me into her.
Look at me. Even in the heat of battle, I'm so elegant, regal. I am Ajax, mighty Greek warrior. God, it feels good to finally pop that zit known as Will Schuster.
Shut up, Sue. Look at us. We're even fighting in our voiceovers.
They did a funk number. We've never been able to pull off a funk number.
Well, that's because we're soulless automatons.
I'm so depressed.
Tell me this isn't true, Rachel.
She could have died.
Oh, I didn't send her to an active crack house. Besides, how did you guys find out anyways?
The Asian community is very tight.
You did this to me. You told Coach Sylvester about my summer surgery.
You have a surgery when you get your appendix out. You got a boob job.
Yep, sure did. You can't hit me.
Well, sure I can, unless you got yourself knocked up again, slut.
Stop the violence.
So disheartening. It is so disquieting. It is so discouraging. Darling, please stop. Answer.
Ring.
See, I really couldn't.
Sing.
I could never really.
Sing.
What I couldn't do was.
And the winner is. By two votes, Sam and Quinn.
What? What? Screw that! I want my stick.
Ooh, let it go. Let go.
Unbelievable.
That was my.
I don't know how this happened.
Son.
Unbelievable.
Now we're a little short on female roles, so we're gonna have to double up on Columbias and Magentas.
It's standard practice on Broadway. It'll preserve your voices.
I like to preserve you in a jar in my basement.
Coach Peace, we think you're awesome, and even though you're all hard and tough on the outside, it doesn't mean you're not the opposite on the inside.
Like a chocolate turtle.
Totally. You're nougaty. We totally get that now.
Sweet Jesus, who bought tickets to Crazy Town?
All right. All right, guys. I have one word for you. Brittany.
Is it love? Totally gonna graduate now.
Thank
you. I know that we've had our differences, but I can't lie, that outfit is amazing on you.
It looks good on everyone. Penny loafers and tights? Genius.
Outrageous. I mean, my carousel horse sweater should make me look like an institutionalized toddler, but no. I look hot and smart. I feel like Michelle Obama.
Oh my God, you guys look amazing.
Seriously, she's a genius and an icon.
Who is? Brittany, who did you think?
Who knew that taking off that Cheerios uniform would turn her into a fashion institution?
Is this a joke?
No, that sweater is. Who wears a reindeer sweater?
All three of you?
No, this is a carousel horse.
If you want to know what to wear, just look to Brittany.
Look, she took the look from me, okay? I paid her.
You're a terrible liar, Rachel.
I can't believe you would take this away from poor Brittany.
It's sad. You're just sad.
Hey! I need to talk to you. I want my money back.
Well, I used it to pay a publicist.
What?
Jacob and Israel posted a photo, and this website called The Sartorialist named me the trendiest girl in America.
Brittany, I'm trying to stage a comeback here.
Okay, but what exactly are you coming back from? Listen, Rachel, I'm gonna give you some tough love right now. You're not a trendsetter. When people look at you, they don't see what you're wearing. They see a cat getting its temperature taken, and then they hear it screaming. I'm really sorry, but I have to go. I have an interview with Teen Vogue.
That's my man, and his leg don't work.
Tenderoni!
I'm so in love, I may just start crying.
I know what boys like. I know what guys want. I see them looking. I make them want me. I like to tease them. I know what boys like. Boys like. Boys like me. I see you're sad now. Sorry I teased you.
Hey, where's the hate?
Not the point of Glee Club, Sue.
And now performing the hit single, Tick and Also Talk, by rapper Key Dollar Sign Ha, The New Directions.
Yeah, thank you. Really, really good.
Thank you.
But
my butt, Mr. Shu, that song was amazing.
No, I agree. I'm just not sure that it's regionals material.
Mr. Shu, I wrote another verse of Trouty Mouth.
No. Guys, just...
Gonna find my baby, gonna hold her tight, gonna grab some afternoon delight.
My motto's always been, when it's right, why wait until the middle of a cold, dark night?
When everything's a little clearer in the light of day.
Holly here.
Yes.
So I'm a little confused. Isn't this a strange song for the celibacy club to sing?
Why? It's so wholesome. It was written during the bicentennial to celebrate America and fireworks and...
No, it's about sneaking out for a nooner.
Yes, exactly. A nooner's when you have dessert in the middle of the day, right? Right, Carl?
Well, regardless...
Hey, Brit. So listen, how about you and I pop in some Sweet Valley High this evening, get our cuddle on? Look, I'd really like to get my sweet lady kisses on, but I haven't been feeling very sexy lately. I think I have a bun in the oven. Please don't tell anyone, okay? Especially Artie.
Yeah, sure. Your secret's safe with... Oh my God, Brittany's pregnant.
Oh my God, Brittany's pregnant.
It's only a matter of time.
For what?
Brittany to get pregnant.
Oh, congratulations!
For what?
Oh, you didn't hear, your girlfriend's preggo. You're gonna be a baby daddy.
All right, folks. Regionals is in a week. It's time to get deep into our set list. Artie, you okay?
My life is over. How am I supposed to support a baby? How could you not tell me about this?
Wait, Brittany, are you pregnant?
Definitely. I'm so sorry, Artie. I didn't want to upset you. I thought I could surprise you when I dropped him off. Pretty sure it's a boy.
Babies don't get dropped off.
Wait, Brittany, have you been to a doctor yet? No, that's the only way to be sure.
I don't need to go to a doctor. I just need to look outside my window. 3 days ago, a stork built its nest on top of my garage. I'm not stupid. It's obviously getting ready to bring me my baby. I know where babies come from.
And that's when I realized you were right.
Let's go! Health and wellness jazzercise class! Do we feel our...
You betrayed me. And in case you haven't heard, I like to play dirty.
I don't even remember putting that in there.
The greatest songs are about hurt, and that's the side of yourselves I want you to get in touch with.
That should be easy. Coach Sylvester tortures us for no reason and tries to get the entire school to hate us.
Yesterday, she filled Brits in my locker with dirt.
Okay, slow down.
Well, she literally throws sticks at me. What are you doing?
Throwing sticks at your head? I'm gonna crush you at regionals. It's time to fight fire with the flaming flames of additional flamey gay fire. Porcelain, you will wear this flapper dress and perform at nationals as Porcelina. You already have the lady gait and the lady voice. You'll have to start smoking, though, because this dress is a size 2.
Okay, just because I'm gay does not mean I like to dress up like a woman.
Oh, come on.
What about Halloween, Kurt?
Trick or treat, bada bing.
Hey, what's a guy gotta do to get a candy situation up in here, huh?
Okay, that was a Halloween costume, and it is a far cry from starting out on the stage at Nationals in a dress.
A little more bite, a little less bark. A little less fight, a little more spark. No abres más y abre tu corazón y satisfáceme.
Emma, we're really getting married.
Part of me is everybody there because if everybody's there, I want to thank you all for coming to the wedding and appreciate your going even more. I mean, you must have lost... Today.
Need some punch, do you want anything?
Oh yeah, I'll take a cup. But just remember, we're not
dating, we're just here as friends. Like,
ooh, baby cupcakes.
I don't like the way you treat Blaine. There, I said it. You're here, you're in New York, you're at Vogue.com, you're at NYADA. Who are you, Kurt? Meanwhile, Blaine is here, lonely, and yes, he cheated. And we're all human, Kurt. We all deserve to be loved back, Kurt.
Okay, Tina, I say this with total love, but the moment we all saw coming is finally here. You're a hag. You're hagged out, you're in love with Blaine, and it's creepy. Stop.
What do you know about love? You just come and go. Who's been here to support him? Me. Who took him to City Hawkins? Me. Who put him in bed when he got sick and rubbed vapor up on his little muscle chest while he slept?
What? You, huh?
What? No, I didn't mean... This isn't about me, Kurt. I have to go.
Did you vaporate my ex-boyfriend? Don't walk away from me, Tina. Let's finish watching Moulin Rouge before we lose power again. Or start eating each other.
Oh, no. Please spare us. If I see one more scene of Satine coughing up blood into a handkerchief, I'm gonna start coughing up blood into a handkerchief.
Come on, Santana. It's so good, and we're right in the middle of it.
Let's put it to a vote.
Yep. Oh, house vote. I say yay.
Yay.
Yay. Moulin Rouge it is.
Well, what about Brody's vote, or do drug dealers not get to vote?
Okay, he's not a drug dealer. Please, okay? It's snowing outside. He's probably just stranded somewhere. Do you want me to call him? Okay? I'll prove it to you.
Hey, Rach.
Hey, babe, where are you?
The bridges are closed. I'm stuck at my friend's house in Manhattan. You remember Leo, right?
Well, Donna, one of us farted, and I'm about 60% sure it wasn't me.
Fine, have it your way. The chemical toilet stays bolted to the choir room floor.
Fine. Maybe I'll just throw a Sue Sylvester-style rebellion tantrum as I leave this office.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, no? It goes a little something like this.
No! No!
William, stop that. Michael Schuster. Becky, no. Don't even think about it. Becky, no. Don't.
Wait, this is anarchy. We can't all just shout at the same time. That's better. I have some ideas already. I'm thinking that the music needs to be really simple so we can really highlight our voices. No guitars or nothing electronic. We go with a simple piano arrangement, which I could play.
I'm assuming you're singing lead.
Well, I am a senior and this is my last go at it. We need to win this.
Feels like North Korea up in here.
Okay. Forget the piano. Forget all the music. We can just do, a cappella. That always works.
Deja Warblers. Should we wear matching blazers, too?
Let's take it back. What was wrong with the guitars?
Nothing. Why can't you guys just stop resisting me for a second and just go with me?
Okay. Blaine Jong-il.
Yes, Blaine Jong-il.
I am not trying to be bossy. I'm trying to give the benefit of my experience. I have won more show choir competitions than anyone in this room.
You suck.
You don't want my help? Then I'm not gonna give it.
Looks like somebody's menstruating.
I heard that. Oh, what the hell are you doing?
Nothing.
What about Nurse Penny, Sam? Would you just forget about her? And Tina, you're just, oh, I can't.
I'm sorry, it was the 11-hour energies.
The cheap sort of nostalgia.
This was supposed to be our night. Our little family, our friendly threesome. It was our last chance to hang out together, and you ruined it.
Actually, that was Becky with her twister.
Blaine, come back!
Blaine!
Who is it?
It's Blaine.
Hey, Are you okay?
I was on to you the second I saw that weird cinnamon roll selfie you took months ago. You guys posted that, remember that? I get to New York and all of a sudden it's Elliot thinks this and Elliot thinks that and Elliot's hair is so full and thick that he doesn't have to rely on hair gel. Wow. I may not be a cool steampunk glitter rock vampire with like tats and guyliner, but you know what? I love Kurt. I love him. He's my fiance, not yours. So back off.
Okay, are you done?
I'm so sorry, I should go.
Hey, wait a minute. You just got here. You wanna just hang out for a minute? I mean, you've obviously come to jam.
You gave me this.
Glitter rock vampire, huh?
I didn't mean that, I'm
sorry. I like
sorry.
That, I can work with that.
Okay.
Come on, give me some blues, give me some southern, come on.
Glitter rock vampire,
gonna bite ya.
Guys, I can't stand it anymore. I have to tell you something. I have chlamydia.
What?
What?
Oh my God.
Yeah, I know.
Are you serious?
Yeah, the doctor called me and said I tested positive.
How is that possible?
I don't know how.
Well, do you wear condoms?
No.
Well, that would be how.
Artie, are you kidding? Well, one time I bought some, I got nervous because they were locked in a cabinet, and the pharmacist asked me what kind I liked, and I panicked. So then she gave me these ones that were all greasy, and they smelled like banana. It was like putting on a tiny, greasy, banana-flavored wetsuit.
No, Artie, okay, there's no excuse. That is completely irresponsible. You have to wear one every time.
Stop yelling. I'm sure he feels bad enough.
No, Blaine, this isn't okay. Artie needs to be slut-shamed. I'm slut-shaming you, Artie.
You're lucky you just caught chlamydia. I mean, you could have caught something that can't be cured.
Yeah, you could have gotten somebody pregnant. Just think about that.
Slut shame.
Well, I'm sure you're getting treated, right?
Yes. I take antibiotics for 2 weeks and then I go for a checkup to make sure it's cured.
Yeah, so the girl you slept with.
Which one?
What?
I'm sorry, which one?
Yeah, I've been sleeping with two different girls.
Who are you? It's like I don't even know you.
Sam, calm down.
Hey, boys. Did you know there's an epidemic in this country? Well, there is, and it could be hiding in your trousers. Do you know what an STD is? It's a sexually transmitted disease, and the numbers are skyrocketing. And don't think you're not in danger just because you're a handsome idiot, a debonair homosexual, a hapless invalid, or a strapping male soprano.